All right, welcome everybody. I hope you enjoyed the last discussion and got some pearls of wisdom out of that and some ideas. We are going to, regardless of what this says, this is not a webinar. And we looked through all the details of these slides to make sure that we had exactly what we wanted in there. But apparently we did not look at the first slide. So it's not a webinar. Nobody's going to be coming in from the internet. We're going to go over some of the basics of Holganix, some of the discussion points to consider, what it is, how to communicate that, and some good case studies that we've had, and real-world experience. So if you have any questions along the way, make sure that you ask them right away. If I'm going to be covering it later on, I'll tell you I'll cover it later on, and just tell you to be quiet. So let me grab this clicker, and we'll fire away. So as we discussed earlier, we're focusing on biology as a solution to turf and plant health. So my background, as Barrett explained before, it was in lawn care. And I was 100% granular, 100% synthetic, didn't want to have anything to do with anything organic because in my mind it did not work. The reason it didn't work for me was because I looked at it as a one-time try and it was an event. It was not a process. It cost three times the amount of money to put down an organic fertilizer. So where's that money coming from? Coming right out of the profit. So the experiment, in my mind, would fail every single time just because there was no ROI on it. So given that experience, there is a better way. There is a balance that we can have through this process. And we'll go into what a hybrid program is, how to implement some of these different products, and real-world use of it. So why does biology matter? Every plant that we deal with is in soil. Does anybody have any plants that they're working with that are not in soil? What, Mike?
Sand.
It's a soil type. Sandy soil, right? But golf courses have sandy soil all the time, and it's a problem. We have different soil types. We have different soil, and he's on my team, too.
Yeah.
We deal with this every day. We have a conference call every day, and he's bringing up stuff like that. But it's a valid point. So we have different soil types all the time, different soil ecosystems to consider. So it's another variable. I mean, as if weather wasn't enough, we had the variable of not knowing what's actually in the soil at the time that we're trying to take care of it. So Holganix Bio 800. We've typically called this Holganix. This was the product that started our product line. This is the product that is basically the Cadillac of what we do. It has all the bells and whistles, and it is designed to make a fundamental change in the soil ecosystem. Every positive that we bring up about what Holganix can do, this product can do it. Now, if you look at really what is the important aspects of it, increased tolerance of stress from weather, disease, and insect. We don't know what we're going to face each year, so that's obviously an added benefit. We don't know how much disease we're going to have, what diseases we're going to face, and what type of drought situations we're going to run into. Root growth. Root growth seems to be one of the most important things when we talk about plant health, overall plant health. You know, how are we going to, when you think about just lawn care, not even landscaping or tree and shrub care, but lawn care, every single customer that you have is paying attention to what the lawn looks like, but they're not looking subsurface. But we're fighting, if we're not paying attention to the roots, we are fighting a very difficult battle to keep that top growth looking good and looking healthy if the roots are not healthy and not extensive. Improved water retention. Obviously, with improved root growth, we're going to have improved water retention, but it's more than that. The biology that is in the Holganix Bio 800 is literally addressing that issue. So it's different within different years, different parts of the country, it becomes more and more of a relevant issue. Golf courses pay attention to this all the time because they are constantly watering. If you have customers with irrigation systems, it's obviously important to them. They've made an investment into it. But I cover the Northeast, and north of, I would say, northern New York and across into northern sections of New England last year, they had a pretty bad drought. Everything south of New York City, we didn't really see it. If you thought that you had it, you didn't have it. They had it bad. And one of the things that the lawn care companies in that region started to do last year was, rather than trying to force nitrogen to get some result when there was no water, they just started using Bio 800 as a straight application because it was able to convert the nutrients that were already in the soil and get them a result that had no burn potential, did not need the water that nitrogen needed. So it was obviously a component of their program that gave them some flexibility and gave them the ability to keep production going. Because really, in lawn care and landscaping, tree and shrub care, everybody wants to make plants healthy, but we make plants healthy to make money. So the economics of this have to make sense. That was one of the ways that they it had a direct relationship to that. Enhanced nutrient uptake. So we talk about the reduction of pesticides all the time. You also get an NPK reduction. The overall uptake of the plant is increased. The biology within the soil is converting usable food sources at a faster rate. We'll go into that in one of the next slides. That overall ecosystem is like a metabolism, that the faster you can get it working, the more nutrients if you have a high metabolism, you can take in more nutrients from the food that you eat. Well, if you can do that, then in some cases you can eat different foods. You could eat more or less. Well, we have dialed it in so that we can use less nutrients to get more out of them. And then foster a balanced soil ecosystem with active microbes, 800 plus active microbes, hence the name Bio 800. Going right into that. So Bio 800 product line has 800 species of active diverse microorganisms, 8 sources of microbe food, 3 sources of nutrient enhancers, and then other micronutrients. This is living biology in a bottle. You know, you see all the refrigeration systems here, you see the big cold rooms over there. Everybody know why it's refrigerated? What's the simple answer for why it's refrigerated? It's alive, but why would we have to keep it cold? What happens when it's cold?
Dormant.
Becomes dormant. So if we want to use it, do we want to use it when it's stale or when it's fresh? Fresh every time. So we make sure that we keep it dormant so that when the application is done, it is working at the exact same time and it's at its peak performance the same time that you're putting down other ingredients so that we can utilize those conversion rates. This is what I was going to jump ahead to and didn't. So this is the soil food web. This is a very, it's not generic, but abbreviated form of what the soil food web is. And we focus on from about here down. So the nematodes, the fungi, the protozoa, bacteria, organic matter, into the roots. There are populations within the soil that we're constantly focused on. The reason why we have so many micronutrients in the Bio 800 is because you don't know what's going to be missing in the population of the soil. So if you don't know what's missing, how do you know that you're fixing the problem? Well, when we go into that, we're applying that product and filling in those gaps, increasing the populations, and therefore we're able to increase that soil metabolism. So we mentioned the hybrid program before. Typically, what we did was we would have our NPK sources, we would have our pesticides to control all the weeds and fungus and insect problems that we would have, and we would get the green weed-free lawn that we would need. I swore by this for years, because every time I tried to vary away from that, it didn't work. And I ended up needing more NPK or more pesticides in order to accomplish the result. So it was not only that it initially cost more money for an application, in order to get back to the aesthetic result that we needed for our customers, it cost more money to do that. And now, with Holganix, you add in your organic components, the plant probiotics, you can use 50% less fertilizers and up to 75% less pesticides. And that's not just over time. Some of those are immediate. I just wrote a program Monday for a customer and immediately reduced their pesticides by 50%. Some of it has to do with what they're using, what rates they're using it at, but I have no doubt in my mind, based off of the results that we've seen in the Northeast, that they will absolutely get better control combining Holganix with their pesticides in the same tank and be able to use 50% less of them. So when we talk about the cost of an organic fertilizer and adding that in, I was saying that it was three times the amount of money. Well, a lot of times this can be cost neutral because of the reductions that you get. A lot of times it may add in a little bit more. It depends on what you're willing to give up and what you're not willing to give up, what products you're comfortable using, what, you know, suggestions you may take for other products to use. And you can, you know, get to a point where it can work for your budget. You may not have to adjust all your prices. So we have some testimonials.
Hi, my name is Brandon Haley, certified grounds manager with Red Diamond Coffee and Tea in Moody, Alabama. I won't plant anything on our property without Holganix. The Red Diamond corporate campus just received the PGMS Green Star Grand Award in the commercial and institutional category. Recognizes commitment to sustainability, levels of maintenance, turf and landscape, and recognizes the challenges that we have on the property. This is the second time we've won this award, and I'm so thankful for my crew and the support that we've gotten from our corporate office. It's really shown, and we're able to put out an amazing product. Irrigation usage has been a very big focus of our department, and we have cut back our total gallons used by over 75% in the last 3 years. Holganix has been a good part of that this year because our root system was so deep that I could go extra days without having to water. This year I was able to get an extra day out of each irrigation cycle, and a lot of times we would get a pop-up thunderstorm in the afternoon, which then would get me a whole nother week. And so right now we're on roughly a 5-day cycle on irrigation, and its results have been amazing. We have a pretty efficient use of fertilizer on our property. We use a one-time application fertilizer product, and over this year we were able to cut the usage down to just a little bit over 2 pounds of nitrogen per thousand, which is lower than I ever thought I would get on high-end Bermuda grass. Next year we are going to be cutting it down even further to below 2 pounds, and I really don't plan on stopping until I see diminishing returns on the grass. We started at just a little bit above 3 pounds of nitrogen, by about 3.3 pounds of nitrogen per thousand. And so this year we went down to 2.4, and our target's going to be between 1.8 and 1.9 next year. Our soils are heavy clay that need aerification to even be able to put a shovel in the ground. We've been able to consistently get roots down in that 8 to 10 inch zone, and they're dense and obviously are working because we can keep cutting our irrigation back more and more. We wanted to enter the root, greatest roots contest, or however you term it, and we found one area of the property that had, I mean, it was 12, 13 inch roots. I do have a picture with the ruler next to it, but in the clay soils, it just, by the time the shovel gets down there, you're destroying it, and you know, I'm sure there's some much better pictures out there that are going to win, but it does work in clay soils. You know, the roots are that far down, you just have to find them. This year we were able to do a landscape renovation at my house, and we put down a 18-wheeler load of 10,000 square feet of Bermuda grass. Being like anyone, I really didn't want to pay a large water bill, and so I tried Holganix. We went out at the 14-ounce rate after the sod was put down, not before, I'm sorry, and watered watered it for 4 days. At the end of the fourth day, I was not able to rip the sod from the ground and was actually able to cut it on the fifth. A riding lawnmower, riding on the grass, not a single rut, not a single torn piece. Out of 10,000 square foot that we laid down, I lost half of one piece of sod that was actually outside of the irrigation zone to begin with, and it never would have lived long term. I could not have asked for anything better. And your yard looks great. The refrigeration Holganix initially scared me, but Holganix was able to get me a refrigerator, and we're able to get product in stock, keep it chilled as it needs to be, and it's ready to go when we have to apply. So that's been a great help, and I have a lot more belief in a product that is refrigerated versus one that may have been sitting in a warehouse for untold months or years. I don't have the strongest microscope, so I just got to see it moving around a lot, but it was definitely a lot, and that was something that really impressed me, because I've tried a lot of other products in the past, and you don't always know what you're getting, and I really felt value for the money with Holganix. Any plant that goes in the ground is getting Holganix. We've tried different methods of drenching afterwards, dipping plants in a mixture, dipping plants in the product straight out of the bottle. I'm seeing great results. I don't know yet which one works better, but plants are looking great. Annuals are twice the size that we used to have with just a couple weeks in the ground.
So believe it or not, that was not scripted. So a couple of things that you heard in there. Anybody dealing with clay soils? Only three quarters of you? It can be a real pain in the butt to deal with. It creates a set of circumstances that makes root development difficult. When you heard what he was saying, and one point, when he discussed 14 ounces per 1,000 rate, that's an inoculation rate. When he used that for the sod. So that's not a typical rate that you would always go down at. That's not a maintenance rate. It's more of a kick in the pants, if you want to think of it that way. Like, if you have no idea what you're dealing with in the soil and you know that you have to get a result, put it down at 14 ounces and you'll get the result. let's look at another one. Barrett mentioned Tomlinson Baumberger earlier. And again, this was actually a video that we were not planning on doing at all. We were at a barbecue together, and one of their marketing people said, hey, we can do this.
Hi, Rob McCoy from Holganix, here with Ryan from Tomlinson Baumberger. Thank you for having us out here today, and just wanted to ask a couple questions. Ryan, how long have you been using Holganix?
This is our second full season.
So, okay.
Yeah.
What have you seen as far as differences in using the product as compared to what you did before?
We've seen an increased level of stress resistance in our lawns, a lot of nutrient uptake without using the amount of pesticides that we previously had in some of our other programs.
Okay. So you've recently incorporated Blue Sky into your program.
Correct.
How long ago did you incorporate that into your program?
We started that in late spring this year.
Okay. And what rate are you putting that down at?
We're putting that down at about a quarter pound, and it complements our other inputs as well with the Holganix and the light rate of pesticides that we put in.
Okay, great. And what results have you seen with incorporating Holganix and Blue Sky together?
We've seen a great color response, high satisfaction from our clients. And we see that as a product moving forward that's going to work well for us.
Fantastic. Well, Ryan, I want to thank you for your time. Appreciate all your help. That's it from Rob with Holganix.
Tomlinson Baumberger was in their second season of using any Holganix product. The number one thing that they saw was a reduction in disease activity. which they were not using the product for that reason. But because of the microbial activity, there was an automatic disease reduction. So they didn't track their reduction in fungicides, but you can imagine with how expensive fungicides can be, and that it's never something that you're really charging for within a program. It's always an added-on thing. There's two costs to consider there. One is the cost of the fungicide that you have to do, the cost of going out there to apply it, but then what's the real cost of capital, relationship capital that you have with your customer already that's looking at their lawn and saying, well, why does my lawn look like this and my neighbor's lawn doesn't look like this? You know, how good of a feeling do they actually get about that? So disease is something you don't know when it's going to pop up or how bad it's going to be. But if you can have something that's naturally a disease suppressant that's working for you all the time, that's a huge advantage. And with the amount of customers that they have, that's a big deal. The other thing was the reduction in pesticides. They went with a 50% reduction in pesticides. They probably, after their first application and their second application, they went with a 50% reduction in pesticides and carried that through, and they were in their second season of that and seeing great results. They also combined Blue Sky, which is a 2100 methylated urea, with Bio 800, and were able to combine those two sources to get a really good green throughout their summer months. And that was actually just recorded in July when they started using Blue Sky a little bit before that. And the combination of those two products seemed to be a home run for them. And then we are going to take a little bit of a golf approach here. And this one I will not blow up, but it's right here. This is Rob Dillinger, one of our golf course reps.
Good afternoon. Rob Dillinger here with Holganix. Alongside me today, I have Paul B. Latshaw, Director of Grounds Maintenance here at Muirfield Village. He's been kind enough to join us and do an interview today, so thanks for joining us, Paul.
Good to be here.
All right. Very good. So I just wanted to talk a little bit about the Memorial Tournament and kind of what goes into preparation and maybe a little bit about Holganix. So what goes into course preparations as far as projects, hours, products, people? You know, kind of just give us a little background on what all goes into it.
Well, it all starts with people. Obviously, all the programs we've got to execute starts with the staff and people, making sure that you have a really well-trained staff and able to work the hours. Tournament preparation, a lot of people think it's really glamorous, but you know, you start doing 12-hour days and multiple days and string it together, fatigue starts to set in. But it's one of those things that once you get through it and you've accomplished your goal and have all the patrons out here and the players, it's really satisfying.
Awesome. Great. So how has Holganix helped during preparation for the tournament? Like, what does your program with Holganix typically look like?
Well, we obviously start with a base program on greens, do the inoculation rate, and then we try to go every 2 weeks with the product, really trying to help out with developing root systems. Everything we're really doing right now with lowering heights of cut, trying to get the speeds we're going to achieve for the Memorial, is really counterproductive for plant health. So it's a matter of trying to have your plants as healthy as possible to be able to withstand the stress of the tournament, and not just the tournament. When you get done with the tournament, make sure you have a good golf course for your membership to play. And I think that's one of the keys that we find with the Holganix along with our other programs, are that we're trying to really emphasize plant health to be able to sustain good plant conditions, not just for the Memorial, but for the membership.
Okay, excellent. So you just kind of told us where you use it. So what kind of effects have you seen with Holganix? You know, you mentioned deeper rooting. Have you seen anything with, you know, color or density or playability? And I mean, has it really affected any of those in particular?
I think, you know, definitely the rooting.
Okay.
You know, one thing I really like about it is we don't see a flush of growth with it. We've also used it in other areas. You know, this time of the year, we've still battling the emerald ash borer. We have trees that are going down. And a lot of the trees are coming down are in areas where we have patrons on.
Okay.
So we're actually, you know, less than 3 weeks out, and we're still laying sod. So we make it a program to try to make sure that we spray the Holganix onto that.
Okay.
To make sure it helps root quickly. So that helps out immensely with trying to get the sod established quickly.
Okay, great. And is there anything in particular you like to pair with Holganix whenever you're spraying it out, or does it just go in with your typical foliar program? Or
You know, we do with our soil spray on Mondays on greens, and sometimes there's wetting agents in there. There's also our TGR program for, you know, trying to suppress our poa along with other nutrients. So it goes in every 2 weeks. Now, if we're doing a fungicide, say like a Banal or something for root pythium, we won't put in the tank with that. But it's every 2 weeks, and we try not to put a fungicide with it and just try to have it be with the other programs, which, you know, there's always obviously nutrients. There might be magnesium in the tank or manganese. Obviously, potash is always in that program because USDA greens is really hard to register and maintain potash levels.
Right. Okay. Great. And so real quick, when was the President's Cup? In
2013.
Okay. So I'll do that next question. So what about post-tournament and getting the course back to shape, dealing with turf plant stress? So I guess that kind of ties into everything else that we've talked to, but is there anything in particular that you've used Holganix post-tournament, given the beatdown that, you know, patrons and everybody else, you know, will do to a golf course after an event like that?
Yeah, we've used it a lot for restoration areas. Obviously, all the tents that are up here, a lot of those areas are decimated after. So once again, if we're sod in an area, we'll use it for that. We've actually put it in the tank when we hydroseed big areas.
Okay.
And we've really seen good germination and good establishment with adding that to the tank.
Awesome. Very good. So in 2013, you did a huge renovation between the Memorial and President's Day. I'm sorry, the President's Cup. Let me say that again.
Yeah.
In 2013, you did a huge renovation between the Memorial and the President's Cup. Can you tell me about that story? Where was it?
Mr. Nicholas wanted to add some length on 18, okay. So we built a new tee 40 yards back, but it wasn't just that tee. It was everything around it, all the tees in front were altered and changed. We moved about 7,000 cubic yards of soil. I forget the exact date, but I think we laid the sod on the tee somewhere late August, and knowing that we're playing the President's Cup first week of October. Getting the bank grass established was obviously a major concern, and then also getting the hillside where we're going to put the patrons getting established. So we started going with the Holganix on a two-week rotation, started with the inoculation rate, and we were able to get the tee established perfect. All the areas around there got established. We didn't have any issues with patrons slipping or anything like that, and the sod being rooted. And the other thing with that is a sod came in August, came pretty hot, and we actually questioned if we should lay it or ship it back and get a new load, and we ended up taking a chance, and I really think that helped out. The Holganix coupled with that, we also used turf screen on top to help a little bit with that, and that seemed to really help out with the establishment.
Wow, great. What kind of time frame was it between the Memorial and the President's Cup?
Well, Memorial ended that year sometime in June, first week of June. Okay. I think we started construction on that tee July, and then the President's Cup was the first week of October.
Wow, okay. That's great info. Give me just a second here. I need to say my last piece, because that's it.
As much as you want.
Yeah, that's it for video one. So,
you can wrap it up.
Yeah. Well, thank you for your time, Paul. We greatly appreciate you doing this video.
Thanks for coming out and helping.
Murfield Village is where they hold the Memorial Tournament for the PGA each year. It's Jack Nicklaus's tournament. It's in Ohio. They use Holganix on all of their golf turf, all of their landscape, all of their plant installs, and within their greenhouses. So they're using, within that Bio 800 line, they're using Bio 800 Goff, tree and shrub, and bloom for all those different reasons. That will be on the, you said that'll be on the video later on?
I'll put a direct link and play it through the video. So.
Fantastic. All right, we briefly touched on combining the Blue Sky 2100 with the Bio 800, so we're going to dive into that a little bit. So enhancing nutrient uptake. Think about, you can add any fertilizer in with the Bio 800 and get a great result and be able to do a reduction. This is a much more synergistic value because of the way that we're designing the fertilizers to be a specific complement for the Bio 800 product line. So you're going to get enhanced nutrient uptake, increased soil health, extra nutrients added into it, and obviously I already stated that it was a great complement. So the prebiotic fertilizers, we have a 2100, a 21020, we have our Grow, Flower, and CalMag. We are specifically putting nutrients in that the Bio 800 is going to be able to use and be able to increase that soil metabolism. Three sources of microbe food, two sources of nutrient enhancers. So you can see the synergistic value that we're going to face. So with 2100, everybody loves a methylated urea. It's a nice high quality fertilizer, the 2100. One of the things that's different about this is how long it lasts. We're getting 12 to 16 weeks of coverage with the Blue Sky. I have sod farm in Buffalo that because of, for those of you that aren't familiar with sod farms, when they seed, they don't go on top of that soil for 8 weeks at a minimum. They don't do any more treatments. There's nothing that's done. So it and that first 8 weeks is critical for the entire span of time before they get to harvest that sod. So they use a product like this because it has that extended even release of nitrogen source the entire time, and it's also increasing the soil ecosystem. The 210-20, I mean, for some of you, how many people are from New Jersey? Sorry. Can't have it. Anybody from New York? I don't think we have anybody from New York. They can't have it either. But it's a great source of potassium and phosphorus. Again, built the same way to complement the Bio 800 so that you can get the most bang for your buck and really the bang for your time that you're investing into using it. Phenomenal for root development and new tissue development, you know, and increased water efficiency. So the Holganix four-part garden program, this is a balanced program that we actually came up with for greenhouse specific and garden growers. This is designed as a 12-week program, but it can be redesigned in any way that someone sees fit. Yes.
Is this in for like tray production in greenhouse or just general containerized production in greenhouse?
I would think that you would be able to tailor it either way. Barrett,
yeah.
That's a good question. Can you ask that question again? So we're talking about the four-step garden program.
Right.
He asked about in container production or...
is it like for trays, for annual production, or more like shrub, like woody plant material in, you know, 3 gallon production? What type
so
of
this particular program is designed for very high-value hydroponic crops that are grown indoors typically.
Medicinal cannabis.
That's the primary market for it. You know, it's not going to be real cost-effective for commercial nursery growing. It's going to be cost-effective for somebody who's doing a small garden in their backyard. It's going to be affordable for somebody doing any kind of, you know, even indoor, you know, hydroponic tomatoes, lettuce, that kind of thing. But we have a lot of distribution in Oregon, Washington, Colorado, and those customers are what the primary market this is designed for. So from a cost perspective, it's people that aren't using a lot of material but want a big result. So probably not for most of what you're doing. We got stuff that we can help you with, but I would do it in different formulas that would be more affordable to you.
Yeah, and I would incorporate bloom right away on something like that.
Yeah, bloom or tree shrub.
Yeah. That answer your question?
Sure. Similar to this, the first presentation you made talked about doing a soil smart program.
Yep.
Offering. It's a good idea. What would that program be for a lawn care company that's traditional?
There's a couple things we can do. One is we've got pre-done programs we can just kind of hand you. Here's programs that people in your market have used that work real well. We could sit down with your people and design the right program for you based on what you want to get done. Do you have direct information on Thomas and Baumberger's exactly what they're doing in their Soil Smart program?
They didn't change much other than adding Holganix into it. Now, they added the Bio 800 product line into every application that they're doing. And because of the reductions in the other pesticides and NPK, that was the major change. That's 95% of the change that they made. And the rest of it is on the fly.
It looks to me like this is, you're basically adding like a compost tea to get all that microbiology in there. And then, so is this a way of getting around having to do the compost top dressing, and I guess it's so the other stuff that you're adding is kind of taking the plate, or are you missing anything by not adding compost?
I don't think so, but...
So look, if you can compost top dress every lawn you do, everything's just going to work better. That being said, how many people are going to pay for the time and labor involved in compost top dressing your lawn? Not very many. So what we offer is a very simplified way to take some of the things that you would find in compost. And it's not just simply a compost tea, it's a compost tea extract that's engineered. We isolate the biology that we want to reproduce, and we make those populations, you know, very high concentrations compared to a traditional compost tea. Traditional compost teas, you don't always know what you're getting. It's very inconsistent, and you usually have to buy a lot of volume to get the result. What we're doing is a highly concentrated, more of an engineered process, so we get a very repeatable product with high populations of the biology we want. Doing a compost top dressing is beautiful, and if I could have an unlimited budget, I'd compost top dress and I'd put down Holganix. The Holganix is going to turbocharge the compost. But the reality is most people won't pay for that, but they still want the effect. This is a great way to get it. Every time you put down Holganix, you're getting a lot of that biology that you get in a compost top dress. You might not get all of the organic matter that you get in a compost top dress, but you gain the biology and you get some organic matter. Put it down over and over and over again, and you will change that soil the way you might with a compost top dress, but you would do it slowly over time. Yeah.
So, we've been talking about liquid the whole time. This is obviously not an option for everybody. It depends on the type of equipment that you're using, how you're doing your applications. So, we have probiotic fertilizers. We have a 243, a 523, 795, and a 1023. We use Healthy Grow in combination with Holganix to achieve these results. You can go to Aquarius right now and get a bag of this and apply it to your lawn and get the benefit of a fertilizer and 7 ounce rate of Holganix. The only difference is that you can't do your reduction in your pesticide inputs. So you're still getting a reduction in your NPK. Great solution, seen phenomenal results with that.
By the way, there's samples of that material sitting up here on the desk if you want to just take a look at it for consistency and real time.
Some success stories. So Wilmington Blue Rocks, right down the street. We work with Steve on a regular basis. He was able to cut back his fungicide applications from 15 per year to 2 or 3. And that's exposed. I mean, I've been on that field, and he mentions that his roots are now 6 to 8 inches. They're longer than that now. This is probably a year old, this slide. They're longer than that now.
He went to Kentucky Bluegrass, mowed at a half inch, with 150 events a year on the fields. So when he's doing 20 fungicides, it's because he's not doing what you guys are doing with residential lawn care. He's pushing that turf at a level that's not normal.
Healthy.
But to go from 15 to 2 is, he thought, was remarkable.
And now he's using Holganix Bio 800 Golf with Blue Sky. And that's his standard combination that he uses every single time he goes out and does an application.
How many applications does he do a year?
It depends. It depends. But he was going out about every 4 to 5 weeks. And again, he's really pushing growth to make sure that he doesn't have the luxury of having time to see it dip off and then do an application. There has to be a lot of overlap in that program.
You got to understand too that if they've got 30% chance of rain, they cover the infield with tarp. So if you want to breed disease, you put a poly tarp on top of half inch mowed bluegrass right before it rains. So that's why he has so much fungus and disease pressure. So what he was doing, spraying Holganix before he covers it with a tarp every single time. So he could do it multiple times in a week in that area that he tarps. But again, he's stopping that disease pressure because you get active beneficial organisms, the pathogens can't thrive. That's where we get these
people. Again, Pittsburgh Pirates, Manny Lopez, after using Holganix, was able to reduce inputs by 50%, had 9-inch roots, and he's got a cut, actually, and I think they're right here. You can see some of the differences of applying Holganix to stressed and damaged areas of the turf. That's a 3-day difference.
That's active dollar spot. It's active dollar spot on third baseline. They had a hypersensitive ball player that would not allow them to apply fungicides within so many days of him being on the field from another team. So he had active dollar spot, was going to be on TV, couldn't apply fungicides. Went and put that Holganix at a heavy rate, said, what the heck do I got to lose? This is how we got Manny Lopez as a customer. And within 3 days, we got recovery. That was a super phenomenal result. It doesn't exactly happen like that every single time. But I will tell you that it is a great tool for recovery on active dollar spot.
So what would they typically do if they couldn't do that? Paint the grass. But it's not the same playability. So one of the things that all the major league ballparks are very concerned with besides the aesthetic look, is actually the playability of the turf and the thickness of it. So they have to make sure that that stays consistent. So even in foul territory, this is important. Terry's Lawn Care in Morristown, Indiana. This is three examples after seeding. This was dirt, by the way. So there was no grass there. 12 days after seeding, 22 days after seeding, and 7 months later. The 7 months later maybe isn't that impressive, because we've, you know, all seen really good results when it was meticulously cared for 7 months later. But it would be really nice to know that if you started from dirt, that 22 days after that you could have a lawn. You know, those types of results are important in certain circumstances when you have a difficult customer that you're trying to work with. Cincinnati Reds. This is just a great example of how he was using Holganix. And I love this comment. I don't even know if you can see it down here. Holganix, don't know what that means, but cool. Check it out. It's 100% organic, chemical-free, plant probiotic for the soil food web. Holganix can be used for many applications. It's coming straight from the Cincinnati Reds groundskeeper. Here are some examples of bloom. This is actually backwards down here compared to the pictures up top. There's bloom with Blue Sky versus Miracle-Gro. You can see how much more full the plants on when you're up top. The plants on the right have Holganix. Down bottom, the plant on the left has Holganix. You can see the difference there. I don't know what amount of time that was. Does anybody remember? Still, same amount of time for each potted plant. Here's an example from Murfield Village. We were discussing this earlier. After a full year of Holganix program on the greens, the increased density in root mass. Paul says it right there in the quote. Biggest benefit of Holganix is root depth and density, especially on the greens. This is one of my favorite stories of all Holganix stories. So for those of you that know golf and are fans of golf, so there's a few different tournaments that are not necessarily annual tournaments, like the President's Cup. So Paul decided that he was going to excavate the 18th tee box and make it 40 yards longer. He did that 7 weeks ahead of the President's Cup. So he was already using Holganix and understood some of the effects of it and had some confidence in it. So this top picture is 7 weeks ahead of the President's Cup. This is 3 weeks ahead of the President's Cup. 1 month difference. That is the same hole with the tee boxes extended. Pretty incredible. So he put down 14-ounce rate of Holganix, 1.2 ounces of turf screen, 20-20-20 at a tenth of a pound, and foliar pack micro plus at a quarter ounce per meter. Here's an example in Mike's area. Mike, you want to share any information on this?
That was in Southeast Houston in 2015. A customer came to me and said he had a yard that looked dull. And I said to him, I said, well, what are you looking to do? I said, how much do you water, et cetera? He said, I got to get it to pop. And I sent him out there with actually, I can't read that.
795.
Yeah, we sent him out with a bag of 795 and 4 pounds a thousand, and I told him to overspray. Believe it or not, he took tree and shrub. I don't know why he bought it, but he applied tree and shrub on that lawn, and that was his result. The entire neighborhood called him up and said, what did you do to that yard? Did you paint it? What happened? That one-man band became a superstar in that nice development in Houston.
Thanks,
just,
Mike.
Just by that.
You get a result when nobody else can get a result, people pay attention. It's the purple cow scenario. Everybody can get a result when the weather's good and the conditions are good. What can you do when everything's against you? That's when you're going to stick out. So that's my contact information. Do we have anything else? So, questions? Yes.
What's the difference between that and the 800?
So that is part of the Bio 800 line. Okay. It's specifically designed for flowering plants. We may not switch all the ingredients, but we switch the ratios within the product. So one may be more fungally based, one may be more bacteria based. All what's best suited for the target plant that you're working on. So in that case, it would be on flowers.
Okay.